I'd just like to share something that I've been thinking about for quite a long time, and that is the creativity of our movement and the Heartfriends within it. We all are messengers of something, and our individual message is important for us to deliver to the world because it's part of our reason for being, it's part of our mission, it's part of our dharma, our raison d'etre, our reason for being. If we pull up our bootstraps, I don't know if they have those much anymore, but I guess they do, and we get to the task of being our highest creative self, we as co-creators with God will fulfill our destiny through our messengership, whatever that looks like. By the very fact that we acknowledge that everyone is a messenger and has certain innate abilities, gifts, and virtues to bring forth to the world, it actually liberates our movement from being focused on one individual, one messenger, one leader, who kind of carries the bucket for all of us. Because when we are all empowered to be true to who we are as God-realized sons and daughters, as men and women of light, as re-embodied Essenes, if you choose to accept that you were one of them, or maybe you remember it, it, through that liberative state of being, just frees you to be joyous, to be happy, because you can be complete. And really, when you are fulfilled, that's when you're truly happy. That's when joy really abounds within you. When you are creative, when you are an artisan of the spirit, you're giving your gifts continuously in the sacred dynamic of sharing. Sharing your gifts is tantamount to being a son of God, a daughter of God, and the totality of what that means. Because God created all of us to go forth and multiply, which is, to me, to multiply our talents, our gifts, the graces that we've been bestowed, and to articulate it in very beautiful ways that we and only we can do. Many New Age movements begin under the auspices of one particular guru or spiritual teacher, and then when that one is gone, they collapse, or people don't really take up the calling to the full extent that they could have. And we're not waiting for that to happen. We are empowering each and every one of ourselves to be the point of reference where you live, move, and have your being for God, to invest something dynamic, powerful, magnificent, and auspicious and awesome to the world, and give your gifts. We have a very talented staff that does phenomenal work in this regard, and every one of them is an artisan of the spirit. Every one of them participates in a way that is so profound that I am in awe of our staff, our servitors. Each one is a disciple of the light. Each one is an initiate. And to be an initiate, you have to initiate things. You have to begin things. You have to both begin them and work through them and complete them. So to be an initiate is not just starting things, it's actually fulfilling them by God's grace through your talents and the light that you are privileged to bear on behalf of the world and on behalf of everyone. Because we are all messengers of light, and we are empowered to multiply God's grace, God's gifts through our hearts, our consciousness, our co-creative abilities, we can be fulfilled within our personal dharma, within the greater dharma of the heart center community. Because the community recognizes that it is composed of individuals who are initiates, who make up this sacred body of holy brothers and sisters. We're all at the round table co-equal in our opportunity to give. Even though I may be kind of the spokesperson and have this gift of locution, many of you commune directly with the masters. They inspire you. They overshine you. They guide and direct you. And sometimes the communication is very direct, very personal, and very profound, to the point where you know it's not just your higher self, it's a master. It is maybe your master, your guardian angel, your sponsoring master, or masters, plural. So I will never stand in the way of your divine relationship with your source. All I'm here to do, as all true messengers are, is to be a reminder, kind of a goad at times, and a catalyst for you to be self-realized fully under your own vine and fig tree, as it says in the Bible. So from the very foundation of our movement, this has been a guiding principle that I'd just like to highlight again, because lest anyone have any sense that I'm better than you or that I'm the messenger with a capital T and a capital M, well, you're all messengers. And capitalize that M by doing your work to the max, you know, to the max. So capitalize the M by doing your work to the max. And use the max in light. Use the muscles of your divine presence. Use the massive energies that are flowing through you to amass greater light, greater love, greater beingness. And then through the mercy of Mary and Kuan Yin, through the majesty of Alpha and Omega, through the magnanimity of Lanello, Claire de Lis, and others, you will fulfill your destiny because it is written in Akasha that you will. Do you realize that your destiny is already written in Akasha? You just have to fill in the fire of it. It's like when children have those little coloring books with the numbers, and then they connect them, the dots, and then they create a figure, and then they color it. That's all you have to do. The imprint is already etched in Akasha for what you are meant to fulfill, your destiny, your God presence, your union with your source is already etched. The blueprint is there. All you have to do is connect the dots and everyday work assiduously to be co-creative and to connect them and then color everything in, right? It's as simple as being like a little child again, really, in consciousness. And on days that it's hard to connect the dots or color, just pause, go within, take some deep breaths, spend time in nature, breathe deeply, meditate, get reconnected so that you can connect the dots, you know? Whatever works for you to reconnect. And sometimes you work so hard, you may lose your joy a little bit, and so you have to refresh. Hit that refresh button, okay? And when you are refreshed, then you can be joyous and happy again. If you're constantly in a state of stress, it's hard to remain centered and happy. So the refresh button is there for all of us to utilize, because the intensity of the path sometimes causes that. Well, it doesn't really cause the stress. We self-cause the stress by our attitude and how we feel about our work and service and how we choose to engage, and the burdens that we actually carry are sometimes self-assessed or self-administered. So if you meditate upon how you can undo the stresses, the burdens that you self-assess upon yourself or self-burden yourself or self-administer and relieve yourself of that onus, then I believe that your life will become easier, more profound, more joyous, more happy.